This is a production of PBS 39.
In the past 5 years, graduates of DeSales University's Physician Assistant Program have been academically ahead of the curve. They rank in the 99th percentile for first-time pass rates on the National Certifying Exam. But these days, the students are being recognized for their accomplishments outside of the classroom. Nicole Brewer tells us about the DeSales Free Clinic.
As 24-year-old Brett Feldman pumps some iron at a local gym, it's easy to see why he won a national bodybuilding title. His physique is a testament to the time and effort he puts into achieving his personal goals. But these days, Brett is trading in his squat rack for a stethoscope and working toward another dream, providing health care to the homeless. Now in his second year in the DeSales University Physician Assistant Program,
I guess we'll just follow up from our last meeting.
Brett founded the DeSales Free Clinic in January of 2007. He came up with the idea while he and his wife were looking for volunteer opportunities in Allentown.
I looked into it and there was no clinics available. There was no homeless clinics. So I thought, well, and I'll start one myself.
And with the help of teachers and classmates, that's exactly what he did.
The thing that I'm most proud of with this clinic is that it's completely student and faculty driven, and we've done it together.
The process wasn't easy. It involved research, fundraising, and getting administrative approval. But Brett says he had faith that the project would pan out.
I just had a feeling that this is what we needed and that God was behind the project, and that if I couldn't do it, he can.
And it seems Brett's faith paid off. Not only did they raise $20,000 to start the clinic, they also found space for it at the Allentown Rescue Mission.
The facility isn't very big. It's roughly 16 by 20 feet. But the staff say they don't need a fancy facility, just a place where they can offer their services to people who need them.
I always had it in my mind that we didn't need too much in order to treat these people. We needed just ourselves and the knowledge that we brought and our stethoscopes and our little bit of equipment.
It's filled a big gap that we had in the services that we could provide. We provide shelter, food, clothing, etc., counseling, life skills training, drug and alcohol, but we haven't had that medical complement, and now we do.
As an official part of the DeSales Physician Assistant Program, first and second year students report to the clinic on Thursdays from 6 to 10 p.m.
When the patient comes in, we talk to them, find out what they're there for, if they're having any complaints, if there's anything bothering them.
The first year student then checks the patient's vital signs. That includes everything from taking a patient's blood pressure to listening to their breathing patterns. Second year students like Brett oversee the process, offering help where it's needed.
As P1 students, you know, we're kind of young and impressionable, you know, so we watch the way that the second-year students handle their patients.
And while first-year students may start out slow,
the first few patients, they're sputtering over their words and they're, you know, their hands are shaking on the physical exam.
The learning experience certainly pays off.
But then by the end, they're a lot better, and that's just in a few hours of work.
You can see the maturity as they start to see patients and as they take a more personal interest. It's not so much like school anymore.
After the interview and physical exam,
152 over 98.
The students present the information to the attending. Together, they devise a plan that could include prescribing medication or scheduling a follow-up appointment.
It's always exciting because it's great to see the students and it's great to see them in that role.
This gets us to take a very hard look at real life, and that there is a big underserved community out there.
While the clinic is only open to men at the rescue mission, the students see up to 15 patients per week. Dale is one of those patients.
Well, months ago, I had lost the job and I had my struggles and kind of fell off the wagon and really in bad shape.
Homeless and struggling with alcoholism, Dale says the clinic helped him get through a difficult time.
Currently, I don't have any health benefits, so, you know, this was a great help instead of getting myself into another financial situation, which can be overwhelming sometimes with medical expenses.
Dale came to the clinic because he was having trouble breathing. He was set up with a prescription and an inhaler, all free of charge.
So when we say a free clinic, that's exactly what we mean. Patients don't pay for any lab work, they don't pay for any medications, they don't pay for any visits.
Anything I need, it's offered here, you know, and it's just been great.
And now that he's healthy, Dale says he's ready to start a new life.
It's time for me to get back out there in society and work and give back to society what's been given to me here.
And while the clinic may have experienced success in its first 3 months, the work is far from over.
And we're starting to apply for some larger grants, some operating funds to sort of sustain this over the long run.
What we don't want to do is have the clinic open, have the patients depend on us, and then not be able to fiscally maintain the clinic.
But Brett doesn't see that happening. Not only does he hope to sustain the clinic, he wants to expand it.
The shelter is only men, so we're missing women and children, which are obviously a huge part of our society. So, I can't wait to open up to everybody.
And it's Brett's positive attitude and willingness to work for his dreams that sets him apart as a leader on campus and in his community. For Tempo, I'm Nicole Brewer, reporting.